Hey everyone! I hope this video will bring peace to your mind and rest for your soul. I have to take a pause in the flower series I'm doing, so here's something a little different. This is a time where everyone is frantically looking for hope to their situation, for answers, for clarity. But what if the answers have been with us all along? At this time, a long time ago, there was a woman named Mary Magdalene. It was dark in which everyone was safely tucked inside their homes, and she ran to the tomb of Jesus in the darkness after he died a painful death on the cross. That seems a lot like where we are right now, doesn't it? In a time of death and despair, in the darkness. No one could understand why this had happened, especially for Mary. When she arrived and saw the tomb open, she was frantic. She thought they must have stolen his body. She stood outside the tomb and wept until morning. But that isn't the end of the story. In John 20, verse 14, Jesus is standing before her as she's weeping. He asks, "Woman, why are you crying?" She doesn't realize that this is Jesus at first and says, "Sir, if you had carried him away, tell me where you've put him, and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." And at that simple action of saying her name, maybe it wasn't the way he said it, maybe she recognized his voice, but she turns around and exclaims, "Rabboni," meaning teacher. Guess what? Jesus is calling your name too. He loves you. He loves you. You are his everything. And that's why he died. He didn't want to by any means. He was a human. He didn't want to die such a horrible death. But because he loves you and doesn't want to see you lost and hurting and stuck in your sin, he died so that the sacrifice would be made and so you don't have to live a life in shame. Instead, you can receive eternal life. He has called you by name into his light, just like he called Mary when the sun rose. Psalm 35 says, "Weeping may last through the night, but joy comes in the morning." It may seem like the night lasts so long, and I hear you, friend, but we don't have to stay in the place we were. There are opportunities of growth and joy and peace and grace found in Jesus right here. All it takes is a little faith, because when you know the good he's done in the past, you can brave your today and tomorrow. Fear has no place. Regardless of where you grew up, if you haven't grown up in the faith, or if you have, but you just haven't truly seen the Lord as a close friend and a loving father, wherever you've been, whoever you are, I want you to know that he is with you when you call out to him. He was with you before, he's with you now, and he always will be with you. Even when you don't feel it, he's there. God says, "I will never leave you nor forsake you," and that's a promise. He's calling us into something greater. We are sinful, but because of Jesus, when we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive them and make us whole. Great news, the tomb is still empty. You're forgiven, and he invites you into a place of rest. I know this was a heavy video, but I made this video because you deserve to know that you are loved so much more than you could imagine. He sees you, he knows you, and I just want you to know that. As we have all this time now to think and reflect, let this be a time to make that choice whether you want to be in a relationship with God. He's just waiting for you to reach out and respond. That's where it truly begins. Jesus' resurrection today isn't just his resurrection. It's yours too. You don't have to live in fear and death and shame and sorrow. He already paid it all. Does it mean you won't feel these things sometimes? Not quite, because life is not perfect. But will you find yourself in a place of rest when you run to him? Absolutely. He is a solid rock. I don't know where you are at this point in your life, but wherever you are, you can embrace him now. He's calling out your name. When you weep, he weeps too, because he cares for you and because he knows what pain feels like. I could go on, but that is where it all begins. If that is you, if you've been lost, searching for something to hold on to, if you believe in your heart that Jesus is who he says he is, you are saved. If you want to know more about this Jesus and who he is, I would suggest to start reading the book of John in the New Testament of the Bible. Guys, I'm pretty young, so I'd also encourage you to check out some wonderful people out there who share so much amazing insight, and they love you too. Specifically, check out Sadie Robertson. I'll put a link for her channel and other amazing people like her down below for you to check out. If this is you, I invite you to pray with me as I close this off. Dear Jesus, I see now that you've been with me all along and you loved me. Thank you for dying for me. I believe that you, Jesus, are the Son of God. I confess that I am a sinner in need of a Savior. I need you, Jesus, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hey, feel free to reach out if you have any questions or want to talk further. Thanks for listening, and know that you are so very loved. Happy Easter, and stay fresh, peeps.
Jesus is calling.